Dylan Buckley.
Fantastic.
Yes, good evening. Well, Dayne Beams has achieved pretty much everything you can in footy. He's a premiership player and All-Australian and a best and fairest winner. But at the moment, all that talent and energy is going into another field. Dylan, fluid art. I don't know much about it, but we're about to find out. Dane's going to open up to you.
He is, mate. He's absolutely killing it. Health of mind art. I'm going to have a word with him now.
Go for it.
Beamer, fantastic to be here, mate. Channel 10, health of mind art, absolutely killing it. Painting's flying off the wall. How's it been keeping you busy in COVID?
Well, I'm lucky because I only work here by myself, so there's no restrictions on me. But yeah, it's great. The business came about from me having a visit to a mental health hospital last year. And I tried my hand at art and ended up coming back out of the facility and really enjoying it. The two things I enjoyed the most were the yoga and the art, and the two things that I went in there thinking I'd have no interest in at all. So yeah, it's been really great. It's been great for my health and obviously it's been a terrific outlet for me.
You're absolutely smashing it, mate. It looks fantastic. How important do you think it is for players and people to have that life balance? I suppose playing footy, it's full time, but were you doing this when you were playing?
No, I wasn't. And that was the thing that I struggled with the most. I never had any passions outside of football. So this has been really godsend for me. Like I've been able to, you know, make this my passion, my hobby outside of football, and it's incredibly important because the game is so demanding these days, and there's so much pressure put on players that you need to have a bit of a release. And for so many years, I struggled with that part of that side of things. And there's a lot of players that do well. They play a lot of golf, and there's other things that guys do. But I never had anything really outside of footy, so this has been fantastic for me.
And mate, obviously it's going super well at the moment. You've transitioned out of footy beautifully well. Can you see yourself going back and playing now that you've done so well outside of footy? Is the bug still there?
Look, we're just going to have to see. Like I've, before the virus sort of landed in Australia, I was taking some time off and extended break from footy just to weigh up, I guess, my future and what that holds. So, it hasn't changed. The virus has come along probably at a good time for my own personal point of view, but it's something that I'll do a little bit of thinking over the next sort of few months and we'll land on a decision then, but nothing's set in concrete, and I'm just enjoying doing what I do. It's been a long time since I've genuinely felt happy with life since my dad passed away, so it's at the moment I'm just enjoying it.
It doesn't get better than that.
Mate, 10-year reunion since the famous premiership, 2020. Celebrations might be a little bit different this year. Have you got anything planned with the boys?
We've got a WhatsApp group, and there has been the odd conversation about the dilemma we may be facing. But if it comes to that, I'll just let Dee Swan organise it. I think he'll be pretty good at it. Might be a Zoom reunion. Could be interesting, but we'll make it work in some way.
Who are the key players in that group? I know you said Dane Swan. Who else are the main blokes in there?
We all enjoyed a good time. it was a pretty good group. I mean, we played hard on the field and played hard off it. Yeah, but it was fun. Like, I mean, I was only 20 at the time when we won that flag. So, for me, I was still a baby and I was enjoying being around the older dudes, showing me the ropes.
Mate, I know you put up your premiership medal for sale for the bushfires, which is absolutely incredible. I think the club bought it back. Have you seen it since?
It's still in my drawer.
So Eddie's bought it and he hasn't even taken it.
Yeah, I actually messaged Ed the other day and I said, mate, I've still got the medal you bought. And he said he'll get it. He'll get it off me in due time. So, it was something I actually seen Shane Warne put up his baggy green. That's what sort of prompted me to, put up my premiership medal. I mean, it only sat in my drawer anyway, and it's a materialistic thing that I've got the memories, that's all I need.
Yeah, I put up one of my jumpers, mate. They actually paid me to take it down. So it didn't work too well. Tell me about your life now, mate. You've got your two kids, your beautiful wife. Things look like they're going really well for you.
Yeah, life's good. Like I have, the last 2 years, since my dad passed away, it's been a real struggle for me. My dad and I were really close, we were best friends. Like it wasn't just my dad, he was my, my best mate. And it's taken me a long time to recover from that. So it's just, it's been a work in progress, but I'm finally at the point where I genuinely feel pretty happy with my life at the moment.
That's awesome, mate. And health and mind art, you got the Mother's Day special coming up. Is there anything left?
Yeah, there's always stuff left, mate. I just thought, my mum done so much for me. When I was a young fella, my mum and dad divorced at a really young age, so it was mum copped the brunt of it early on. So, I've always had utmost respect for mothers, and even watching my wife, mother our two children, it's an incredible job the females do. And I just thought, well, I'll incorporate a bit of pink, bit of green, bit of white, and obviously represents Mother's Day, and put it together with a little package, and it seems to be going really well.
So we can get that on the website?
Yeah, you can get on the website. Just check out my Instagram or in my socials at healthandmindart.com, and it's got the package there. You get the painting, you get a box of chockies. What else you get? You get the framed magpie ink poster.
Oh, fantastic.
Oh, sorry, not framed, unframed, but it's signed. And there's one other thing, can't even remember. Oh, and a personal video message from me. And I want to make those really personal, get a bit of info about the mothers. Yeah. Okay. I don't want it to just be Happy Mother's Day, blah, 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 Dayne Beams. I want to, put a bit of effort into it and make them feel really special on the day.
All right, well, if you want one of them, hit him up. Mate, we might get into some art. I know you've already got me going today, so no, it's fine. We'll move on and we'll get into it.
How far off?
You would have been a bit of a graffiti artist on the day, wouldn't you? Your skating day?
No comment. Oh, geez, that's hit me now. In the brain. That's a head spin.
I guess, mate, wanting to tap into the art, my big question is how it gets created in your head and how you go about it. Do you sketch it out first or just go?
A lot of the stuff I do is you got to have a good taste for colour and what colours work, because some colours won't work with each other and they'll actually get lost. I mean, in your painting, like if you put a certain colour with a certain colour, sometimes one of the colours might get lost in it because it just doesn't work. So a lot of the stuff I do is pretty simple. I don't like try and overcomplicate things. Like I don't try and throw a million colours in at once. And I like to keep things pretty pretty clean and elegant, if you want to call it that. But for instance, my Mother's Day piece, it's I just try to incorporate the colours that represent Mother's Day. So it's something a little bit different as well. Like a lot of people, everyone's got their own. I mean, some of the stuff I do, I don't really like myself, but then other people love it. Like, so it's just it's an individual thing. Like, some people like some things and other people, and some things that I love, people hate. So it's one of those things, yeah.
Have you kicked the footy at all? Or are you just, in a full, no footy, hasn't even entered my mind?
To be honest, no, it hasn't. To be honest, the 12 years I've been in the system, I don't think in my off seasons I don't kick footies either. We're talking about off seasons. Like, that's my break. I'm not going to kick a footy in my break. I took some time away to deal with the stuff I needed to deal with. So the last thing I really want to be doing is thinking about too much football. I respect that it's my job and it's there, but I respect my health more. And that was the priority at the stage.
Mate, it's amazing to hear the passion. That'll do for me, mate. I'll get back to deal, but this is a bit fascinating and maybe we can have a bit of a crack and feel what it feels like.
Yeah, for sure.
Thanks, man. Righto, time for the world famous Triton Tray Challenge, courtesy of Magic Hand Car Washers. Magic Hand Car Washers, 13 locations across Victoria, and we're down at the beautiful Fern Tree Gully offering today. Now, Beamsy, you haven't been kicking a lot of footies. Are we a bit nervy about putting the skills on the line?
Yeah, the quad's a bit jittery. Not too sure how I'm going to go. I haven't kicked for a while.
You were a beautiful kick and you will not have lost it.
Can't get any purchase on the kick. Here he is, Beams! Steps on through!
You never really had it. You used to run a bit fast, but we need to sanitise. So we've got the magic sanitiser that is...
Is that a wart? Is that a tap?
Sano up, Beamsy. Okay, nicely done. And now we better run through the rules. Yell them, because you haven't got a mic.
One kick, 30 metres, let's go.
All the best, son, you won't have lost it. Pump it a bit, Beamer. Commentate it, son. Oh, nice connection. Oh, connection. All right, big head.
So, boys, Beamer, what you want to do is aim for something behind the goals. MCG.
And kick it
like that. Oh, don't mind it. Oh, right into the badge. You badged it. It's all in the drop, boys. Oh, nah, short. Oh, just go, that's pants. That's run a lap of the pool table. Shocking, I shinned that. Well, Beamsy, the ball drop was perfect. Just a few too many weedies, mate. You ended up on the highway.
Yeah, I might have put on a couple. Been in a good paddock, but execution we'll work on a little bit.
The quad's okay, and the ball felt good in the hands, though?
Yeah, it'll feel better out of it, but yeah, she's all good.
Well, for being a good sport, and we really appreciate you having a bit of fun with us, you get a really nice prize here. A 12-month unlimited wash club membership with Magic Car Wash from only $299 at participating locations. Magic Wash Club, cleaner, safer, faster. That is the novelty check, and you will have a clean car for about a year, mate.
Outstanding. Thanks very much.
Thanks,
Batman. Cheers.
Well, there we go, Dayne Beams. I knew he was a beautiful footballer and a beautiful kick. I didn't know he was so funny. A funny man, great to see him smiling.
Mate, he's an absolute ripper. Like you said, he's funny, he's cheeky. I played against him a couple of times and he wasn't as nice on the field as he was today.
Bit of a sharp tongue on the field, did he?
He was cheeky.
Cautionary tale for all footballers. Dayne has admitted there that he wishes he found the art and found an interest away from footy when he was 22, not 30.
I think that's it, mate. You know, all these young guys coming through, probably they're just focusing a little bit too much on footy. If you can find that passion outside of it, it just makes you a bit more of a well-rounded person and a bit more of a life balance.
Great to see him well. Reckon there's any chance we see him at the Pies again?
I don't know, mate. He seems pretty happy now. He's killing it with his art. Look, yeah, I know a lot of Pies supporters would love to see him out there, but like I said, he's got a great family, seems happy, so that's all you can ask for.
As you say, yeah, important to see him smile above all else. Now, I want to know about the podcast. Luke Shuey, controversial figure over here, even though he's Victorian, was ducking on the agenda.
It was, mate. Luke Shuey, absolute champion bloke. Lucky enough to have him on the potty last week on Dylan Friends, and yeah, he spoke really well. 2018 Grand Final, obviously about Dom Sheed, breaking the hearts of some Collingwood supporters. Obviously spoke about the duck as well that he got against the Port Power and knocked them out of the prelim. So he was a great man, and I think we're going to have a little listen to it.
What were you thinking at this time? You got to override it.
I was thinking, I can't believe I've gotten away with ducking again.
Yeah.
I remember looking up and the runner came out and he said to me, mate, there's 5 seconds to go. You kick this, we win. I thought, no, mate.
Here it is.
In season 2017, he's kicked a goal. The Eagles have won.
So that'll do us. Deal on 10, week 3, if you don't mind. And the views are rising and the sponsors are coming in there. I'm hearing there might even be a studio getting built. Hey, what can you tell us about next week?
Next week, we're heading down the highway. One of our other good mates. So it's going to be good. I'm going to enjoy it and hopefully tune in.
A premiership cat?
Premiership cat.
Oh, I can't wait. Deal on 10, next week.
Go for it.
You good?
Always relaxed. Oh, full. It's full. Oh, it's on Burwood.